Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, we are going to see about what is visual headers in Power BI. A visual header is basically a list of options that appear at the top of your visuals. So let us see what are the different options available and how you can control it, whether user wants to see the visual headers or if they wish to don't want to see it, and how to hide it from the viewing perspective. Let's see in this demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. Let's jump into a demo. So now you can see a visual here. So this is typically a visuals, right? So each and every visual is like every chart is your visual. So visual headers are nothing but when you click on a visual, there are a list of options available at the top. This is your visual headers basically. And sometimes if you wish to disable certain options, like I do not want to see this filter, I do not want to show this more options, like that, some of the icons you do not wish to show, or focus mode you do not wish to show. Okay, so how to control them? It is, again, it's one of the property over here. When you click on a visual, you go down and you can see a visual header option, right? So let me go to this visual. You see at the bottom you have another option. So when you expand it, there will be a list of options underneath. There will be a bar appearing for internal to that visual header. Okay, so what are your different options? You can see like drill on drop down and show next level icon, whether you want to enable it or not. I want to set it to focus mode on or off. So now you see the focus mode, right? Once you click on it, it will appear here. Once you set it to off, so this option won't be available. This focus mode won't be available for the user when they are viewing. So there is some more options. So the user can export. Sometimes what happens, you want to show the report, but if you leave this more options, people can export the data and see. So in that case, you want to restrict it. Okay, certain case you disable the more options now. So what I did is initially I made the visual header certain options hidden for this particular visual. So the focus mode is off and the more option is on. So this is sales monthly, whereas for sales monthly WTT sheet, the same visual, okay, similar visual, I didn't do anything. I keep all the options active. Let us see that visual header. So I had a focus mode is on, maybe focus mode on, and more options is on. Okay, and what I need to do, I need to deploy it. Now you can see it. As soon as you change it, you cannot see it. These options are more specific to the viewing perspective, that is the end user when they see the reports on the cloud or at the server or by a report server. Now I am publishing this in my Mac workspace. That is V27 visual header. Let me replace it. So once it deployed, let me go here and refresh. This is my report. So we have one of the sheet, sales monthly WTT, where you get all these options active. In the sales monthly, I set the focus mode everything off. You see, nothing is appearing, only the copy this visual image is appearing. So that is a key difference. So user cannot export the data, or he cannot use the focus mode, some confusions to avoid. So this is the main purpose of your visual headers. Now let me go back to another important option in it. Like here, so now we have seen the difference of once you use the visual header on or for certain icons, you can say I do not wish to appear at all. In that case, just switch it off, visual header, whole thing to off. So no other options will be available. If you want to disable certain options, you go inside the visual header and you can switch it off certain icons here. If you do not wish any of the things to appear, and you can switch it off at the top. Okay, this is point number two. And I want to include some more icons, and that will give me some more information. That is nothing but you have a certain options here. Another, the third point what I am making is, there is something like in the visual header properties, there is one thing called visual header tooltip icon. If you switch it off, there will be one icon will be appearing. Okay, so using that icon, you can pop up and show some other information. Let me show how to do it like this. Let me, I have did it for this particular visual. You can see now. Okay, fine. So what I'm trying to say is, now when you switch it on, okay, now there will be another icon, I mean another option is available, that is visual header tooltip at the top level. Okay, here you have a visual header. Now only after switching this visual header tooltip icon, the another option at this level will appear. Okay, what happens if I switch it off, visual header tooltip icon? So now I'm going up and removing, I mean at this level the visual header tooltip icon, the another option is not disappearing. Okay, what is the purpose of it? Let me show it to you. So once you switch it on, the new option is available. In this you can choose any of the report type to appear as a information, extra information to this chart. So once you switch it on in the visual header, this option will appear. This will give you this question mark, which you can choose from different pages what information you should appear. What information I want to appear is, I want to give some details about this report. Okay, so basically what I have written is, this chart explains the information about the sales amount, and mouse over to view the category wise split to give a navigation look and feel, or I mean if people don't to not aware of this report, for them you need to give some more information. For this you write some script or some certain instructions to the user. So that will be displayed when the user mouse over here. Okay, that is what. So basically you need to enable option, then here you choose the page I created in tooltip 2. So once I click on it, it will appear. I can also choose something also. Now when you choose it, this will appear. Okay, based on the page or what information you have chosen, that will appear here. This should be a report page, that is what it is. So this is one of the coolest feature that will appear. So let me go back to tooltip 2. Now what it's saying, this chart explained what is the sales amount. Mouse over to view the change wise, I mean category wise split. So user can mouse over it, so you can see the category wise split of it. So how you can navigate or some more information you want to give, you can give it here. This is the third point I want to make about visual header. Okay, this is fine. So basically I want to enable or disable certain options, and it can be done using this option. But sometimes you may think like, I don't want to set any visual headers for any of the report. That creates confusion sometimes. If you have 5 to 6 visuals here and people are difficult to navigate between different charts, at that time they do not want to have any visual header itself. I have, so all these things has to be done individual visuals. Click on this visual, I need to go to these options and set it. But I want to do it across all pages, all reports. My visual headers should not appear for any of the options. Okay, in this case, what you need to do? You need to do it at the option settings. There is an option called report settings. hide the visual header in reading view. So if you check this button, you are hiding the visual header in the reading view. So all this property, whatever you set, become invalid. No visual headers will appear in your reporting. What I'm trying to say is, now if you go to this report, some of the reports based on the property chosen, here it's appearing, here it will appear, and other reports also visual headers will appear. Okay, now it's appearing. What happens when I choose this particular option, like option settings, options, and in the report options, I will hide it and save it. Okay, I think I set it right, hide and press OK. Now I need to publish it. Once I publish, no reports will have a visual header. That you are saying, like instructing the Power BI, do not show visual header, that will create confusion, or based on your requirement, it cannot be exported, some other options. Okay, now this is done. Go here and do, before I refreshing, you see these options are appearing, right here also appearing. Now I'm refreshing. What happens now? There you go. There is no visual header, just it appear as a header. Now I'm clicking it. No options are available. Now I'm going here, I'm mouse hovering, nothing is happening. Okay, the visual headers will not appear, but other functionalities will work as such. I mean, when you click on this visual, other visuals will filter. See, so when I click on it, no visual header is appearing. So that is the option available. So I hope you understand the concept of visual headers, when you need to choose appropriate options based on your business requirements. Do subscribe to the channel and share and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.